False.
No, we were a big part of the whole Phantom Lord saga.
Whoa, no, we weren't.
It's like not the bad part.
What are you talking about?
I'm saying not the bad part of it. We didn't do that shit, but you know, like the whole saga was like trading skins and shit.
Melina, what?
No, we didn't do that. We didn't do the skin trading shit, but we were around like that time, Melina, when they did the trading shit.
Here.
Definitely still potential here for Swarm Patrol. Even though they were mostly in an eco, they've managed to pick up a couple of weapons that actually gives them a decent opportunity to potentially find something for this one. That's such an important kill here for Fur, and the timer is running low. There's no more time for food unless he finds the frag right now, and he won't. He does not have a kit, so he won't be able to get the defuse. The round does indeed go in the favor of MIBR, pushing them to 15. Now sitting on match. Not match. Map point here on the first of...
You're trying to slide out there and get the kill onto the player at Coffin.
Swol Patrol ganha o bombear, planta, o MIBR já vai guardar lá, meus amigos. Três, dois jogadores vivos da 100 Chiefs, quatro jogadores vivos do Fúria. É um round pistola do 100 Chiefs. Que isso, Art? Meu Deus, o Art opera. O JKS atira no corpo. Que isso? A carreta furiosa. Meu Deus, cenas fortes, velho. Porra, troquei de jogo de repente, cenas fortes do Fer, mas ó o Taquinho, ele vem como um exterminador do futuro, pega o Food tranquilamente, o Food foi o quê? Ouvido, lido e morto, MIBR, com bombear pra eles, 4, Swol Patrol 1, aqui os caras nem vai, velho, vamos dar uma olhada aí, ó, no jogo do Fúria, porque aí nem vai. Fúria 4, a 100 Chiefs 13, brasileirinho, Fúria 4, a 100 Chiefs 13, velho. Então, é morto pelo Cacerato, 4x3, olha só o spray do Yuri, que coisa beleza, 3x2, 2x2, meu amigo, 1x1, Vini. 14 Fúria, 12 a 100 Chiefs, ô Raquinha, aí você se jogou do Cat, irmão, cê é louco, mano, que otário, velho, não queria falar nada, não sou fiscal de clutch, mas vou falar que, mano...
So either way, in either of these scenarios, MIBR is in fourth out of the six teams in the group.
And Brazil is doing well tonight. Fúria and MIBR.
É isso, velho. Aparentemente, não importa o que aconteça, se acontecer, está acontecendo, velho. É isso, eu não entendi nada, velho. Eu já esqueci tudo, mas a única coisa que eu prestei atenção é que o Brasil passou. Agora, deixa eu entender de...
Thrown by Robs is a very effective one, but a Molotov lands in his position as well. Needs to try and get himself out of this one.
Can he hear them? He can. Lots of steps are coming towards him, and he's already cratered. Jax, he's going to be forced to watch from the sidelines, and now Nex has joined him. Hunter looking to save and dig his team out of the grave. Kenny and Hunter up against it all, up against three. Good catch. Hunter will reveal his position. He's on for an ace clutch. Kerrigan's flank, yes, an ace clutch on the cards for Hunter. That's the only way he can keep G2's hopes and dreams. And the flank is real. He caught, catches another quad kill. I can't believe it. This man will not quit. This man will not surrender. And Kerrigan's gone too.
Oh my God.
One bullet from the AK-47. Hunter refuses to quit.
He potentially here for MIBR, especially considering that the bomb has been planted. They don't have any utility to work with, and that could potentially be an issue with that Molly. It's gonna force Fallen out of position at least somewhat. Freakazoid, oh, he spots the player down towards small pits. Beautiful stuff from Fallen and Fur. Oh my god, Fur catching the final frag as well. He gets a triple in the round, and MIBR somehow with this force buy, they managed to make it work.
Let's do a little bit of, you know, tidying up around here. Does anyone want to take responsibility
for this? Well, it wasn't responsibility on our end necessarily. The information we were given would appear to have led us to believe that MIBR wouldn't have been getting through. However, I read Fallen's tweet and that kind of kickstarted my mind thinking about it. And we've just had it confirmed here that MIBR are through. I'm pretty sure.
Really?
Yeah. They're through.
So wait, were we wrong? With this frozen flank coming in, he'll get a guaranteed kill towards Amanek. He did try and attempt a ninja before.
Wait, if he sees Jax, Jax is low as well.
Going for the ninja? Really? Trying to draw out Kenny.
But oh my
does.
God, he might
and
have it.
He might
have it.
And they're on it. He's defusing. He's going to have to push in. He's tapping at the
toes.
It's not enough. It's going to be 50.
Ooh.
Mouse ports Winston goes for the ninja up in front, and Jax is going to be mad as hell.
Oh, no.
Oh, Lord. He tried that before.
He did, and this time he sticks the landing. Unbelievable, as FaZe have gone 16-7 in their game as well. Mousesports have found series point. What a brilliant play.
Well, obviously, it's all dependent on this game here and now, but what it means is if Liquid win this game, the standings are from top to bottom, from first to fourth, e.g. Liquid, Furia, and 100 Thieves in those top four. If the alternative happens and EG end up closing this one out and picking up the win, it's going to be EG, Furia, Liquid, MIBR. So really the only big difference is the fact that MIBR can still get a spot, but they're grabbable for Liquid in this round. Cirque needs to be careful. There's a gap in that smoke and a player on his close right. He's got assist and Stan with this spray. He's going to go wide. There's another player on the site. Cirque keeps the cover and Stan with a Molotov burns out a lead. It's Naf now with a save gun. Go do it all. And this is a great chance. This is an opportunity for Naf. Will he take it?
He's got a man trapped and he's trying to keep the pressure on, but in the meantime, EG have got control of the bomb site. Molotov gonna force Naf into the open and he sprays them both down. Team Liquid,
nasty.
They managed to get it on the board, 16-13. They close it out here and now they take us to...
Actually, now as it's actually come down to the 1v2 for Azza, so it's a little bit of an awkward spot, but Vinny, he was actually forced out at a ramp by the Molotov, so that's a very easy 1v1 to be taken. The final player now being Casarado, also not being completely healthy and having a kicker. Azza has a little bit of time to work with, goes forward, gets the headshot, and despite the Molotov going down, of course, has plenty of time. Retrieves the op for himself, is going to go ahead and jump in now and get that defuse true and give 100 Thieves that second round now for themselves in a row. The only issue is only living with one player really isn't ideal. Fortunately, they do have a little bit of extra money onto a couple of players, so we will see it.
Three more thanks to the Prime. Yeah, Summit, if I remember correctly, didn't you say that if you got to 35k subs, you would do a cosplay of our choice?
I'm gone.
Nice.
Some poison.
Molly from garage.
Yeah.
One backside.
Один скала, двое улиц. Ноль чисто.
Я спари ноль, Савик.
Сука, я его так прошу. Да, блин.
I just saw Taco tweeting at some of the admins from ESL asking if they're through. And so Taco, if you're listening, if EG win this game, you're through. You're in that top four. If Liquid win this game, it's 100 Thieves who are going to get that fourth spot here in the group.
So if someone wants to go ahead and direct that flow of information to Taco on behalf of us,
you guys should be referring to him as Mr. Epitasio. Okay? Just make it very clear.
Keep it official. Business only.
Line of respect.
Well, Elige getting aggressive. The timing. Breezy has a nade out. Elige.
Nossa senhora, velho. Pode sorrir. Porra.
Oh, yeah.
There you go. Oh, back mid, back mid. Here left, here left, four down. There you go.
Sorry, I got the spray under control. This is what I've been looking for, though, this whole time.
False.
No, we were a big part of the whole Phantom Lord saga.
Whoa, no, we weren't!
Like, not the bad part.
What are you talking about?
I'm saying not the bad part of it. We didn't do that shit, but you know, like, the whole saga with, like, trading skins and shit?
Melina, what?
No, we didn't do that. We didn't do the skin trading shit, but we were around, like, that time Lana. When they did the trading shit.
Here.
Definitely still potential here for Swall Patrol. Even though they were mostly in an eco, they've managed to pick up a couple of weapons that actually gives them a decent opportunity to potentially find something for this one. That's such an important kill here for Fur, and the timer is running low. There's no more time for food unless he finds the frag right now, and he won't. He does not have a kit, so he won't be able to get the defuse. The round does indeed go in the favor of MIBR, pushing them to 15. Now sitting on match. Not match. Map point here on the first of...
We're trying to slide out there and get the kill onto the player at Coffin.
Swall Patrol, ganha ou bombear, planta, o MIBR já vai guardar lá, meus amigos. Três, dois jogadores vivos da 100 Thieves 4 jogadores vivos do Fúria. É um round pistola do 100 Chiefs. Que isso, Art? Meu Deus, o Art opera. O JKS atira no corpo. Que isso? A carreta furiosa. Meu Deus, cenas fortes, velho. Porra, troquei de jogo de repente, cenas fortes, Fer, mas ó, ó o Taquinho, ele vem como um exterminador do futuro, pega o Food tranquilamente, o Food foi o quê? Ouvido, lido e morto, MIBR, com bombear pra eles, 4, suou patrão 1, aqui os caras nem vai, velho, vamos dar uma olhada aí, ó, no jogo do Fúria, porque aí nem vai. Fúria 4, a 100 Chiefs 13, brasileirinho, Fúria 4, a 100 Chiefs 13, velho. Então, é morto pelo Cacerato, 4x3, olha só o spray do Yuri, que coisa beleza, 3x2, 2x2, meu amigo, 1x1, Vini. 14 Fúria, 12 a 100 Chiefs, ô Raquinha, aí você se jogou do Cat, irmão, cê é louco, mano, que otário, velho, não queria falar nada, não sou fiscal de clutch, mas vou falar que, mano...
So either way, in either of these scenarios, MIBR is in fourth out of the 6 teams in the group.
And Brazil is doing well tonight. Fúria and MIBR.
É isso, velho. Aparentemente, não importa o que aconteça, se acontecer, está acontecendo, velho. É isso, eu não entendi nada, velho. Eu já esqueci tudo, mas a única coisa que eu prestei atenção é que o Brasil passou. Agora, deixa eu entender de...
Thrown by Robs is a very effective one, but the Molotov lands in his position as well. Needs to try and get himself out of this one.
Can he hear them? He can. Lots of steps are coming towards him, and he's already cratered. Jax, he's going to be forced to watch from the sidelines, and now Nex has joined him. Hunter looking to save and dig his team out of the grave. Kenny and Hunter up against it all, up against 3. Good catch. Hunter will reveal his position. He's on for an ace clutch. Carrigan's flank, yes, an ace clutch on the cards for Hunter. That's the only way he can keep G2's hopes and dreams. And the flank is real. He catches another quad kill. I can't believe it. This man will not quit. This man will not surrender. And Carrigan's gone too.
Oh my God.
One bullet from the AK-47. Hunter refuses to quit.
He potential here for MIBR, especially considering that the bomb has been planted. They don't have any utility to work with, and that could potentially be an issue with that Molly. It's gonna force Fallen out of position at least somewhat. Freakazoid, oh, he spots the player down to what, small bits. Beautiful stuff from Fallen and Fur. Oh my god, Fur catching the final frag as well. He gets a triple in the round, and MIBR somehow with this force buy, they managed to make it work.
Let's do a little bit of, tidying up around here. Does anyone want to take responsibility for this?
Well, it wasn't responsibility on our end, necessarily. The information we were given would appear to have led us to believe that MIBR wouldn't have been getting through. However, I read Fallen's tweet, and that kind of kickstarted my mind thinking about it, and we've just had it confirmed here that MIBR are through. I'm pretty sure.
Really?
Yeah. They're through.
So wait, were we wrong?
With this frozen flank coming in, he'll get a guaranteed kill towards Amanek. He did try and attempt a ninja before.
Wait, he sees Jax. Jax is low as well.
Going for the ninja? Really? Trying to draw out Kenny.
Which oh my
does.
God, he might
and
have it.
He gets
might
it,
have
it. And they're on it. He's defusing. He's going to have to push in. He's tapping at the top.
He's got
it's
it.
Not enough. It's going to be 15. Mouseports. Frozen goes for the ninja up in front, and Jax is going to be mad as hell.
Oh, no.
Oh, Lord. He tried that before.
He did, and this time he sticks the landing. Unbelievable, as FaZe have gone 16-7 in their game as well. Mouseports have found a series point. What a brilliant play. Well, obviously, it's all dependent on this game here and now, but what it means is if Liquid win this game, the standings are from top to bottom, from first to fourth, e.g. Liquid, Fúria, and 100 Thieves in those top four. If the alternative happens and EG end up closing this one out and picking up the win, it's going to be EG, Fúria, Liquid, MIBR. So really the only big difference is the fact that MIBR can still get a spot, but they're grabbable for Liquid in this round. Cert needs to be careful. There's a gap in that smoke and a player on his close right. He's got assistant Stan with his spray. He's going to go wide. There's another player on the site. Cert keeps the cover and Stan with a Molotov burns out a lead. It's Naf now with a save gun. Go do it all. And this is a great chance. This is an opportunity for Naf. Will he take it?
He's got a man trapped and he's trying to keep the pressure on, but in the meantime,
EG have got control of the bomb site. Molotov gonna force Snap into the open, and he sprays them both down. Team Liquid,
Nasty. They
managed to get it on the board, 16-13. They close it out here and now they take us to...
Actually, now as it's actually come down to the 1v2 for Azza, so it's a little bit of an awkward spot, but Vinny, he was actually forced out at a ramp by the Molotov, so that's a very easy 1v1 to be taken. The final player now being Casarado, also not being completely healthy, and having a kicker, Azza has a little bit of time to work with, goes forward, gets the headshot, and despite the Molotov going down, of course, has plenty of time. Retrieves the op for himself, is going to go ahead and jump in now and get that defuse true and give 100 Thieves that second round now for themselves in a row. The only issue is only living with one player really isn't ideal. Fortunately, they do have a little bit of extra money onto a couple of players, so we will see it.
Three more, thanks for the Prime. Yeah, Summit, if I remember correctly, didn't you say that if you got to 35k subs, you'd do a cosplay of our choice?
I'm gone.
Yeah.
One backside.
Один скала, двое улиц. Ноль чисто.
Я понял. Я спарю ноль, Сайк.
Сука, я его так прошу. Да, блин.
I just saw Taco tweeting at some of the admins from ESL asking if they're through. And so Taco, if you're listening, if EG win this game, you're through. You're in that top four. If Liquid win this game, it's 100 Thieves who are going to get that fourth spot here in the group.
So if someone wants to go ahead and direct that flow of information to Taco on behalf of us,
you guys should be referring to him as Mr. Epitasio. Okay? Just make it very clear.
Keep it official. Business only.
Line of respect.
Well, Elige getting aggressive. The timing. Breezy has a nade out. Elige.
Nossa senhora, velho. Pode sorrir. Porra.
Oh, yeah.
There you go. Oh, back mid. Here left, there you go.
Sorry, I got the spray under control. Mm-hmm. Really, this is what I've been looking for, though, this whole time.
False.
No, we were a big part of the whole Phantom Lord saga.
Whoa, no, we weren't!
Like, not the bad part.
What are you talking about?
I'm saying not the bad part of it. We didn't do that shit, but you know, like, the whole saga was, like, trading skins and shit?
Melina, what?
No, we didn't do that. We didn't do the skin trading shit, but we were around, like, that time
Melina.
When they did the trading shit.
Here.
Definitely still potential here for Swall Patrol. Even though they were mostly in an eco, they've managed to pick up a couple of weapons that actually gives them a decent opportunity to potentially find something for this one. That's such an important kill here for Fur, and the timer is running low. There's no more time for food unless he finds the frag right now, and he won't. He does not have a kit, so he won't be able to get the defuse. The round does indeed go in the favor of MIBR, pushing them to 15. Now sitting on map point here on the first of...
So you're trying to slide out there and get the kill onto the player at Coffin.
Swole Patrol, ganha ou bombear, planta, o MIBR já vai guardar lá, meus amigos. 3, 2 jogadores vivos da 100 Chiefs, 4 jogadores vivos do Fúria. É um round pistola do 100 Chiefs. Que isso, Art? Meu Deus, o Art opera. O JKS atira no corpo. Que isso? A carreta furiosa. Meu Deus, cenas fortes, velho. Porra, troquei de jogo de repente, cenas fortes, Fer, mas ó o Taquinho, ele vem como um exterminador do futuro, pega o Food tranquilamente, o Food foi o quê? Ouvido, lido e morto, MIBR, com bombear pra eles, 4, Swole Patrol 1, aqui os caras nem vai, velho, vamos dar uma olhada aí, ó, no jogo do Fúria, porque aí nem vai. Fúria 4, a 100 Chiefs 13, brasileirinho, Fúria 4, a 100 Chiefs 13, velho. Então, é morto pelo Cacerato, 4x3, olha só o spray do Yuri, que coisa beleza, 3x2, 2x2, meu amigo, 1x1, Vini. 14 Buia! 1200 chifres. Ô, oh, Joaquim, aí você se jogou do cat, irmão. Você é louco, mano. Que otário, velho. Não queria falar nada. Não sou fiscal de clutch. Mas vou falar que, mano...
So either way, in either of these scenarios, MIBR is in fourth out of the six teams in the group.
And Brazil is doing well tonight. Furia and MIBR.
É isso, velho. Aparentemente, não importa o que aconteça, se acontecer, está acontecendo, velho. É isso, eu não entendi nada, velho. Já esqueci tudo, mas a única coisa que eu prestei atenção é que o Brasil passou. Agora, deixa eu entender de...
Thrown by Robs is a very effective one, but the Molotov lands in his position as well. Needs to try and get himself out of this one.
Can you hear them? You can. Lots of steps are coming towards him, and he's already crated Jax. He's going to be forced to watch from the sidelines, and now Nex has joined him. Hunter looking to save and dig his team out of the grave. Kenny and Hunter up against it all, up against three. Good catch. Hunter will reveal his position. He's on for an ace clutch. Kerrigan's flank, yes, an ace clutch on the cards for Hunter. That's the only way he can keep G2's hopes and dreams. And the flank is real. He caught, catches another quad kill. I can't believe it. This man will not quit. This man will not surrender. And Kerrigan's gone too.
Oh my God!
One bullet from the AK-47. Hunter refuses to quit.
He potential here for MIBR, especially considering that the bomb has been planted. They don't have any utility to work with, and that could potentially be an issue with that Molly. It's gonna force Fallen out of position at least somewhat. Freakazoid. Oh, he spots the player down to what? Small bits. Beautiful stuff from Fallen and Fur. Oh my god, Fur catching the final frag as well. He gets a triple in the round, and MIBR somehow with this force buy, they managed to make it work.
Let's do a little bit of, you know, tidying up around here. Does anyone want to take responsibility for this?
Well, it wasn't responsibility on our end necessarily. The information we were given would appear to have led us to believe that MIBR wouldn't have been getting through. However, I read Fallen's tweet and that kind of kickstarted my mind thinking about it. And we've just had it confirmed here that MIBR are through. I'm pretty sure.
Really?
Yeah. They're through.
So wait, were we wrong?
With this frozen flank coming in, he'll get a guaranteed kill towards Amanek. He did try and attempt a ninja before.
Wait, he sees Jax. Jax is low as well.
Going for the ninja? Really? Trying to draw out Kenny.
Which oh my
does.
God, he might
and
have it.
He might
it. Have it.
And they're on it. He's defusing. He's going to have to push in. He's tapping at the toes.
Oh,
it's
it.
Not enough. It's going to be 15. Mouseports. Frozen goes for the ninja up in front, and Jax is going to be mad as hell.
Oh, no.
Oh, Lord. He tried that before.
He did, and this time he sticks the landing. Unbelievable. As FaZe have gone 16-7 in their game as well. Mouseports have found a series point. What a brilliant play.
Well, obviously, it's all dependent on this game here and now, but what it means is if Liquid win this game, the standings are from top to bottom, from first to fourth, EG, Liquid, Furia, and 100 Thieves in those top four. If the alternative happens and EG end up closing this one out and picking up the win, it's going to be EG, Furia, Liquid, MIBR. So really the only big difference is the fact that MIBR can still get a spot, but they're grabbable for Liquid in this round. Cirque needs to be careful. There's a gap in that smoke and a player on his close right. He's got assistant Stan with his spray. He's going to go wide. There's another player on the site. Cirque keeps the cover and Stan with a Molotov burns out a lead. It's Naf now with a save gun. Go do it all. And this is a great chance. This is an opportunity for Naf. Will he take it?
He's got a man trapped and he's trying to keep the pressure on, but in the meantime, EG have got control of the bomb site. Molotov gonna force Naf into the open and he sprays them both down. Team Liquid,
nasty.
They managed to get it on the board 16-13. They close it out here and now they take us to.
Actually, now as it's actually come down to the 1v2 for Azza, so it's a little bit of an awkward spot, but Vinny, he was actually forced out at a ramp by the Molotov, so that's a very easy 1v1 to be taken. The final player now being Casarado, also not being completely healthy and having a kicker. Azza has a little bit of time to work with, goes forward, gets the headshot, and despite the Molotov going down, of course, has plenty of time. Retrieves the op for himself, is going to go ahead and jump in now and get that defuse true and give 100 Thieves that second round now for themselves in a row. The only issue is only living with one player really isn't ideal. Fortunately, they do have a little bit of extra money onto a couple of players, so we will see it.
Three more thanks to the Prime. Yeah, Summit, if I remember correctly, didn't you say that if you got to 35k subs, you would do a cosplay of our choice?
I'm gone.
Come
poison.
Molly from garage.
Yeah.
One backside.
Один скала, двое улиц. Ноль чисто.
Я спарю ноль, сайт.
Сука, я его так прошу. Да, блин.
I just saw Taco tweeting at some of the admins from ESL asking if they're through. And so, Taco, if you're listening, if EG win this game, you're through. You're in that top four. If Liquid win this game, it's 100 Thieves who are going to get that fourth spot here in the group.
So if someone wants to go ahead and direct that flow of information to Taco on behalf of us,
you guys should be referring to him as Mr. Epitasio. Okay? Just make it very clear.
Keep it official. Business only.
Line of respect.
Oh, Elige getting aggressive. The timing. Breezy has a nade out. Elige.
Nossa senhora, velho. Pode sorrir. Porra.
Oh, yeah.
There you go. Oh, back mid. Two left, four left. There you go.
Sorry. I got the spray under control. Really, this is what I've been looking for, though, this whole time.
Tipo alto, molotov no cimento. Round rápido, MIBR entrosado. MIBR fazendo uma boa execução. Vem a flash por cima do Zelsus pra ele poder sair e ajudar o amigo. Olha o Fê. Nada, não tem ninguém aí. 4x4. Nada, não tem ninguém aí. Tá aí. Mano, ó, joga C4, ele falou, mano, não joguem a C4 em mim. Ó, taps, prefires, o Mark, ele tá ali, ó, ele é o solo bomb, ele está solo na B, e ele está ali, olhando o bomb vazio, ele não sabe se tem alguém, o KNG já mata os Zeus, é o momento, KNG já mata dois, sobrou, olha lá. Calma, cai, 4x1, 3x1, tudo nosso, nada deles, o autodirector trollou, mas o MIBR ganhou. É isso, brasileirinho, é isso, ó, latada nele, é isso, 16 MIBR, 12, suou o patrol, 10 map points para o Brasil nesse momento, quanto? 10 match points para o Brasil nesse momento. Até o momento, eu falei, eu tô desde manhã aí falando que alguém ia pagar a conta, tá ligado, velho? E que suou o patrão ia pagar a conta, velho. Tá aí. Começa provavelmente o último round, o KLG morre, o Meyer também, o Meyer tinha levado o Cooper. São 4 jogadores vivos do Soul Patrol, 3 jogadores vivos do MIBR. Eu vou no Fallen, o Fallen tá ali de boa. Eu vou no Taco, não, eu vou no Fer, eu vou no Taco, eu vou no Fer. É Fer e Taquinho. Olha o Taquinho. Vem a Molotov, ele espera, pega a kill de graça. Pega mais uma kill, o Fer traz mais uma kill. Só sobrou o Frikazoid. E aí, brasileirinho, pode sorrir que o MIBR levou. MIBR 16. Suou Patrol, a Patrulha da Maromba. 5.
Underpassed, but really the full depth of that is being kept under wraps until Vertigo, I imagine, where I don't know what kind of Fury we're going to see. Wouldn't be an expert on their playstyle there, that's for sure, or how they've incorporated it. I'm looking forward to seeing what they pull out of the bag. But at the moment, they'll certainly be moving onto that map with a lot of confidence. This round pans out to be what could be the final with 100 Thieves and a full buy. They've got bottom mid control, but Art picks them off with an AWP. And, oh, he sticks around a little bit too long.
Yeah, actually got caught by the player here, pushed up on short. Okay, Henny actually finds himself a couple in towards the ramp, though, so has been able to pull it back in favor of Furia once again. Actually missing that one there on the Gratis faction, but fortunately did have the help from Casarado, so it is all on the Azza now. He's actually over on short, up on the railings. He had a little bit of a chance there to try and catch one player, but wasn't able to do it, unfortunately. Does then get flanked out by Vinny from top mid, so yeah, 16-4. I mean, way more one-sided than I expected that to be. We both went in saying a bup and just bring this straight on to A, despite having the man disadvantage. As a holding a little bit of an off angle, I mean, it's fairly common, so they do indeed clear it. Unfortunately, he wasn't even able to find one, so now that puts Liaz in a tough spot on the bomb site, needing help, which is eventually coming in from heaven, but again, Furia just managing to keep the trades in their favor. They have a Molotov going down then as well to stop really anything from being followed up by that player who is still alive in heaven. Jacob will at least get himself one there after the bomb goes down, but now it's the 2-on-2. Again, no defuse kit currently in their possession. No nades either, apart from that one flash that's already been thrown in. And of course, as they try and cross over, Henny is watching this angle. So there it is, doing some good damage at least onto Jacob, despite not getting the kill. Okay, Jacob actually ends up getting the frag onto Vinny somehow. Will eventually go down, and at this point, the bomb is beginning to tick away. Henny just running it down perfectly. Flash goes in, JKS taps the bomb, but that's it. There's not enough time anymore. It goes down to the headshot in the end either way. It didn't really matter. 16-12, we are going to see Furia being able to make that comeback happen. And
nice.
Easy.
Defusing the bomb.
I see it.
I know, man.
Не держи.
Почему? У меня девочки будут как шпроты лежать тесненько со мной, скоро.
Дина, скиньте клип Дина.
Один прошел налево.
He was on the right side. One close second.
They're going through. I think they're going to smoke.
Three
guys.
Wait, I thought I wasn't sure.
One ten HP.
As active as absolutely possible. Oh, game is live. Holy shit. Game is live. Did I miss anything? Laos with a Twitch Prime. Thank you so much for it, buddy. Appreciate it. We're straight into the pistol. You know what happened last time? We went straight into a pistol. Somebody was yelling. Somebody was screaming. It is Pimp. In a 4v4 situation, has a Glock in his hand. We've seen what he can do with that before. We've seen him ace a Mirage. Now, 3-4. Make that 2-4. Pimp and his teammate left up to themselves. What can he do about this? Pimp in a 1v4 clutch scenario. Could this be it? Are we looking at it again? Pimp gets up! What the?
And not taking too much damage from that exchange either. That is definitely going to go in the favor of MIBR. At least the first rank did go in their favor, and this is a good opportunity. Fallen, brilliant collateral shot. Fallen with a quad kill. The king is back. Maybe that's a bit too early to say, but that was a brilliant round from Fallen.
But holding his position from Secret is Taric, so he's very, very limited in terms of how much he can get done here. This is really the only one-on-one, that duel with Stan, that he might get offered. In the meantime, Stewie and Twists have both gone in. Oh, I think they've caught a time in here, but actually Ethan's gone back. In amongst all of this, Twist has crossed back into the squeaky door, and he will catch Ethan rotating around with the bomb, but he's the last man left.
No.
Ooh, that's a huge kill.
Unbelievable.
And now down to the 1v2. The bomb at the feet of Twist. Cirque and Stan, they still have the man advantage, but they've got to get their hands back on this bomb.
Twist was getting wrapped, but his smoke grenade actually hits that player walking in through the door, and he hears it. He doubles back and takes that kill, and now the fade will favor him. Ooh. Low ammo, and Cirque trades it out. EG keep this one alive by the skin of their teeth. One alive at the end of things, no longer the clean.
It's a hit towards the bomb site. The B player is pushing. Short's going to be compromised in just a couple of seconds. The CT's coming up behind. FaZe have to rush into the site very quickly. They have no idea. The pistol's up behind, taking one kill at least. Nico on the bomb site, he rushed in, but he couldn't find Issa. And as he goes down, Cold Zera is now in a 1v3. AK's picked up, but dropped just as quickly. As Issa falls and Amali goes down, there's 14 seconds. Cold Zera needs to make a move, sees Alexi B swinging out wide. But this should be it. Tucked in the corner, Alexi B is safe. And the bomb, irretrievable, no time left. And Cold Zera. Okay, he finds one kill at least, but MBK is bailing. He knows that they've already won this round.
So early in the round.
And again, OG going out through B, through the tunnels they go, but right into a player up close. Brokey's got the chance to make this work. Flash is going up behind him as well. He snuck in the back through the smoke, and good night and sweet dreams to OG's round. 3 kills for Brokey. And he's even looking for the fourth. The molly in deep, so the push can't come through. They know they've got the bomb on lockdown. And this round fell apart very quickly. What a play from Brokey to stay up close and just sneak right past them around that smoke into the corner.
The issue is Brokey right now posted up, does find NBK creeping forward, trying to see what was going on around the window room. Unfortunately, he does find out there is a player there, but it costs him his life. And look at this, going for the double swing, or at least initially intending to. Brokey didn't try and follow it up, so Ryan just ended up going down for free pretty much, but at least the trade does come back. A one-on-one now, that final player being tagged up. Alexi B is just actually trying to stick this one. Fortunately for Brokey, he does manage to peek out in time and get himself the kill. I'm not sure how close he was on that, but it must have been quite close because he did have the kit. But FaZe, they get that round in the end, bring it up to 8-4, and as I said,
his gun might have dropped out of the heaven. That could be grabbable for Liquid in this round. Cirque needs to be careful. There's a gap in that smoke and a player on his close right. He's got assistant Stan with his spray. He's going to go wide. There's another player on the site. Cirque keeps the cover and Stan with a Molotov burns out a lead. It's Naf now with a safe gun. Got to do it all. And this is a great chance. This is an opportunity for Naf. Will he take it?
He's got a man trapped and he's trying to keep the pressure on, but in the meantime, EG have got control of the bomb site. Molotov gonna force Snap into the open and he sprays them both down. Team Liquid,
nasty.
They managed to get it on the board. 16,
you know, tidying up around here. Does anyone want to take responsibility
for this? Well, it wasn't responsibility on our end necessarily. The information we were given would appear to have led us to believe that MIBR wouldn't have been getting through. However, I read Fallen's tweet and that kind of kickstarted my mind thinking about it, and we've just had it confirmed here that MIBR are through. I'm pretty sure.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah. They're through.
So wait, were we wrong or were we given wrong info?
We were given the wrong
info. Bomb plant down. EG may as well just go through this smoke. They can wait it out as they group up, even boost, but it's going to fade before the boost is necessary. Plant is late. Twist is dinked, and he's going to get pushed back to the corner of the site. Allege, great shot. He's picked up a P2K. He's making it work. Ethan in the clutch has a low HP target, finishes it. Pistol trying to find the headshot to Naf. He doesn't know it's one-on-one. He's checking long, but now realized the bomb ticking, and he can just stick it. He has a kit. This could go very wrong for Naf.
Oh, no.
Oh, dear.
And Naf's like, oh, dear. The kill comes in. Naf at least gets that to consolidate.
Whoa!
O Cooper, velho, hoje... Olha, matou a galinha na... Mano, o Taco, ele matou a galinha na smoke, velho. Mano, o Taco, que isso? Que jogada do Taco, velho. Matou a galinha na smoke tabelada, velho. Pelo amor de Deus, velho. Eu nunca tinha visto isso, velho. O round perdeu o sentido depois que eu vi isso.